Hello everyone. Good morning. It's good to see you this Saturday morning as we count down to the big election results in two states, in Maharashtra and in Jharkhand. As I begin here, sending up a prayer on behalf of all of us that the verdict is decisive in both states and doesn't spill into the arena of resort politics. Because remember, ladies and gentlemen, we the citizens pay for that too with our taxes. 288 seats up for grabs in Maharashtra, 144 is the halfway mark. No single party in the last 34 years has managed that number, ladies and gentlemen. Jharkhand, 81 seats in the state, the halfway mark is 41. Again, in its 24-year history, no single party has managed that number. So coalition politics, with all its complexities in both states. Also, let's not forget, 46 assembly seats across 13 states and two parliamentary seats that saw by-polls will also be seeing their results coming out today. That includes Priyanka Gandhi's poll debut in Wayanad. As we speak, ladies and gentlemen, the big piece of breaking news coming in is that counting has begun in both states. Of course, the first to be counted and the first to be off the block are postal ballots. Opens up at about 8 o'clock, and that we are given to believe has now started counting now on all 288 seats in Maharashtra and 81 seats in Jharkhand.
Candidate from the Shiv Sena Shinde faction, Saina NC, has reached out to seek blessing of Ganpati Bappa early in the morning before the result. Ma'am, you have seek blessing of Ganpati Bappa. What all Ashirwad has he given and what have you asked from him?
So as a Mumbaikar, every single citizen knows the power of Ganpati Bappa, and it cannot be completed without visiting Siddhi Vinayak Temple. So I have only taken the blessings, and I hope that Ganpati Bappa will make sure that the Mahayuti works towards a Viksit Bharat and a Viksit Maharashtra.
Today happens to be one of the most important days, not only for all the candidates, but Maharashtra also. So what are the key issues, because you have been giving out various issues that people have voted us for this. What do you think will be the change maker for the Mahayuti Alliance partner?
I think the Mahayuti has done a fantastic job in 2.5 years. If you just take the Mukhyamantri Ladki Behen Yojana, it has translated to 2.5 crore women who have got 7,500 rupees into their bank accounts. Of that, if you see, when women want to be empowered socially as well as be given an opportunity to start a small business from home, Ladki Behen Yojana empowers them to do so. So I think the women are with us. If you talk about the youngsters, whether it's the stipend scheme, the internship scheme, they are with us. If you talk about the farmers, the direct transfers into their bank account, MSP, they are with us. And if you talk about the senior citizens, they are aware of the pension schemes and they are with us. So I think all four segments of society, as our Prime Minister says, there are four vote banks. One is the farmer, one is the Mahila, one is the youth, and one is the senior citizens. All these Labhartis have challenged the Mahavinash Agadi and are showing their support to the Mahayuti.
Other than issues on development, this time we saw how polarization was at its peaks. Various slogans were also raised. Do we feel that will also bring a bigger benefit?
You know, the opposition has only played a false narrative. If you see the kind of Tushtikaran ki Rajniti, they will pander to vote banks and keep them downtrodden. The difference is, when the Prime Minister says Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Prayas, Sabka Vishwas, it actually percolates down to every citizen, irrespective of caste, creed. Unfortunately, the MVA has had no...
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was Shaina NC there speaking to our reporter. She had gone to Siddhi Vinayak. Divine intervention required. For which alliance is the question? But even before the results start pouring in, and the first lead should be coming in another half an hour to 40 minutes or so, the posturing has already begun. Because the big question by the end of the day also will be, who will rule India's richest state All right, the first bleed, as we were talking about, the first lead is coming in for the BJP. We'll get you more details. These numbers will constantly update themselves, ladies and gentlemen. But do remember, these are only leads and trends. They do change as we get along and get into the territory of 10 a.m., 11 a.m. and 12 p.m. Remember, Haryana, that's a big lesson for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, poster wars, which have been underway in the state of Maharashtra, now intensifying. And this is not just any poster war. There are now posters that have been placed this morning near Matoshri saying that Uddhav Thackeray should be the chief ministerial candidate if the Maha Vikas Agadi comes to power. As I said, ladies and gentlemen, most exit polls have been predicting an edge for the Mahayuti, which is the ruling alliance. But within the Maha Vikas Agadi, who will be the chief minister if it does manage the magic figure of 145 plus? Well, according to the Uddhav Sena, as it is now called, it should be Uddhav Thackeray. These banners in Thane have been put up, which say, and then there are banners in Thane that have been put up as well, which say, again, Shinde Sarkar, which means even on the other side, you have the Game of Thrones as far as the chief ministerial seat is concerned being played out. Let me go straight across to my colleague Abhishek, who is joining us on the broadcast. Abhishek, over to you. Show us the pictures and tell us the story.
Yes, definitely. You know, I'm right present at Kalanagar Junction, right beside 500 meters from Matoshri. And this is the poster. I would like my cameraman Tushar to show you. Here is the poster of Uddhav Thackeray, and it is clearly written in Marathi, Kutum Pramukhas Honar Punha Mukhyamantri. That means the head of the family will again become the chief minister of Maharashtra. And it's also written, Garv Se Kaho Hum Hindu Hai. You know, definitely, this is what we are discussing from the past 2 days, because Maha Vikas Agadi is not ready to accept the exit poll, firstly. And, you know, preparations and strategies are being formed within the Maha Vikas Agadi, who will be the chief minister. We heard the statement of Nana Patole, you know, claiming that it will be from Congress, and then later he changed his stand after the counter from Sanjay Raut, where he said that no formula has been decided. MVA will collectively sit together and decide on the CM phase. And this is what yesterday Ramesh Chennithala also told to us. So definitely, whether it is Uddhav Thackeray or someone from the Congress, or will there be a surprise from the NCP of Sharad Pawar faction, is something that we are clearly looking forward to. But, you know, as the counting starts, you know, the dynamics will certainly change. But as far as the posters are concerned, similarly, we can understand in Mahayuti also, we have posters of Devendra Fadnavis, in fact, Eknath Shinde, under whose leadership they say that, you know, the entire election was fought, but they don't declare him as the chief minister's candidate. But on the other side, Ajit Pawar is also mulling for him that, you know, what will be his numbers so that he could claim to the CM post. So this is all being decided and strategies are being formed. But last to
Abhishek,
conclude, you know, it will be the key
Abhishek,
of
you have
the
spoken
government
about,
will be in the hands
you've
of independents.
Spoken about posters that have come up in Thane. Let's quickly put out those posters that have come up in Thane as well, which are again saying, Apki Bar Shinde Sarkar. Once again, this time you will have the Shinde Sarkar. Those are pictures that are coming in from Thane. Similar posters have come up outside BJP headquarters. Only this time for the chief ministerial post, the pitch is for Devendra Fadnavis. And does Ajit Pawar have some hopes? He has hopes, but can he be king or will he just be kingmaker? That will completely depend on the numbers that are coming out. So Abhishek, you were talking about not just Uddhav Thackeray, but you have his one-time friend turned foe, Mr. Shinde, Eknath Shinde as well, hoping to be chief minister once again, because those posters in Thane clearly indicate that the Shinde Sena is very clear. Banega chief minister to hamar aadmi hi.
See, definitely, you know, we are, in these kind of statements have been made from past 2 days when exit poll has favored Mahayuti. In fact, right from incumbent MLAs as well as ministers from the Shinde camp. And one thing that we need to understand is, you know, BJP has also agreed, the entire Mahayuti, that we have fought the election under the leadership of Chief Minister Eknath Shinde. But will he be repeated is something, a big question mark. In fact, you know, irrespective parties have their top brass or the senior leaders as chief minister. If you talk about BJP party workers, they are favoring Devendra Fadnavis. When we talk about NCP, they say look forward to Ajit Pawar. And when we talk about Shiv Sena of Eknath Shinde, all the leaders, they want Eknath Shinde to be back at the seat of Chief Minister. But definitely, will that work out is something? Or let me tell you, BJP has always surprised Maharashtra, and it's an unpredictable politics of Maharashtra. You know, what we predict or what we decide is different has happened. You know, remember at the time of 2019, something like that can be, big surprises could come ahead. But as of now, as per the posters around, definitely in both the camps, and most importantly, after the split of parties, you know, there are four regional parties and two national parties in the game. Then everyone claiming they are senior leaders to be the chief minister. But it will be after the counting concludes and looking at the situation.
There's a problem of plenty in Maharashtra.
Yeah.
Abhishek, thank you very much. There's clearly a problem of plenty as far as Maharashtra is concerned. Ladies and gentlemen, so confident is the BJP that jalebis are already in the making in the BJP headquarters. Now, the logic that is, of course, always given is that, you know, the BJP is a party which has a tradition of hospitality, which means if you show up on election counting day at the BJP headquarters here in Delhi, then the least you will get is jalebis and samosas and khasta, which is in true North Indian tradition. So, ladies and gentlemen, the point is that Maharashtra's election is as golmol as the jalebis that are currently being made in the BJP headquarters. Will the state give us a clean and clear mandate, or will the election results and what happens after that go around in circles? That's a question. As we see these pictures coming in from the BJP headquarters, already confident of a win, because aap meetha kab banate hain, when you're confident, when that some good news is going to come. A piece of breaking news coming in. We believe that ahead of the election results, Sharad Pawar's camp of the NCP has already started contacting MLAs of the Ajit Pawar faction of the NCP. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's not just the NCP. I'm being given to believe that at least the two regional parties, as far as the two regional parties are concerned, they have split up in the last 4 years since the 2019 election. Leaders are in touch with each other from both factions, and this is open season. Anyone can go anywhere if the results are not very clear. The only thing that will not happen is the BJP and the Congress coming together. Beyond that, anything can happen. Let me quickly go across to my guest this evening. Ali Daruwala is spokesperson of the BJP, joining us on the broadcast. Gautam Seth is spokesperson of the Congress Party. Advocate Sushil Vyas joining us, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena. Thank you very much. Dr. Naveen Kumar, spokesperson of the NCP. Dr. Sameer Dalvi is spokesperson of the NCP. And Chandrasekhar Jha, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena, of the Uddhav Thackeray faction, joining us on the broadcast as well. And Ashutosh Mishra, senior journalist, with us as well. Good morning to all of you. Good to see all of you. Ali Daruwala, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning to everybody in the studio.
It's 8:13. Good morning. I hope you've got a cup of coffee, because it's going to be a long day for you and for everyone involved. But news coming in seems to suggest that the opposition camp in your case, which is the Mahavikas Agadi, already is confident that they will get the numbers, but they are reaching out to the Ajit Pawar faction as well. Are you a little worried? Because Mr. Ajit Pawar is known to be flexible. Wo subah 4 baje ya 6 baje kahan oath le le, kisi ko pata nahi chalta.
Exactly. And I'll tell you one thing. This narrative that getting the Mahavikas Agadi on the toes is none other to be blamed but Mirror Now. The first show that you did, ma'am, and the exit polls that you played, you have just sent jitters into the party. And it's from then that they have woken up with your show. And all this game of rings has started ever since. And you can be rest assured that nobody is running to anybody's scam or contacting anybody. That is at least is on our agenda, and we have got so much in our plate to handle with, and we are not indulging in all this. As far as Mahavikas Agadi is concerned, I'm sure only you are to be blamed for sending them and giving them sleepless nights.
No, but here's the point. It seems that sleepless nights to thode are in your camp as well. because you have also booked resorts and kept helicopters ready.
Nothing is just a path and is just to misguide and to get the people's attention away and just go enjoy, because we are not going to waste time. By 5:30, 6 in the evening is going to be clear mandate. And I think Monday, not being very overconfident, Monday, I think the game should be over and we'll be done with work. And we need to get on, because Maharashtra, we have done certain things which need to be rectified and we need to start working. And time and again, people have been portraying Ajit Pawar in the bad light as to he can do anything and he'll be the game spoiler and all. I can tell you the fight between the Kaka and Bhatija this time is genuine, and we should not read between lines, because had it to happen, the amount of people who went into the Tutari, I'm sorry they're using the Marathi word, because they went into that party, everything, our party is empty of defectors.
I would say you shouldn't be that confident. Is there a chance of the BJP emerging as the single largest party in the state? Well, the fact is that the BJP has fought on the maximum number of seats, 148.
Yeah.
So statistically, that is a possibility. Your flock may be safe, Mr. Daruwala. Your flock may be safe, Mr. Daruwala, but fact is, are the flock of your two allies, which is the Shiv Sena and the NCP, safe? Sawal wo uthta hai. Anyhow, speaking of straight across to Rakesh, my colleague. Give me a minute here. I'm not talking about Eknath Shinde, but there are people within the Eknath Shinde camp as well who could be open to going over to the other side, in your case, the dark side. Rakesh, you are outside Sharad Pawar's residence. You are Sharad Pawar's residence. And the news is coming that Sharad Pawar ka jo faction hai, NCP ka, wo Ajit Pawar ke faction ke kuch MLAs ke saath in touch hai. Lekin Rakesh, aap to Maharashtra politics bahut pehle se कवर करते हैं, ये बताइए कि ये सिर्फ शरद पवार और एनसीपी की कहानी है इस समय महाराष्ट्र में, या ये शिवसेना की भी यही कहानी है?
देखिए, शिवसेना की भी यही कहानी है, और हमने 2019 में देखा है कि महाराष्ट्र पॉलिटिक्स में कुछ भी मुमकिन है, एनीथिंग इज पॉसिबल इन महाराष्ट्र पॉलिटिक्स. तो इसको लेकर के एक तरफ हम जहां बात कर रहे हैं महायुति की, दूसरी तरफ हम बात कर रहे हैं महाविकास अघाड़ी की, एक जो फैक्टर है उसे नजरअंदाज नहीं किया जा सकता. अगर चाचा और भतीजा दोनों के अगर जो आंकड़े हैं वो अगर मिला करके 50-60 क्रॉस कर जाते हैं, तो वो भी दोनों अलायंस के साथ बार्गेनिंग पावर में आ सकते हैं, और ऐसे में एनसीपी का चीफ मिनिस्टर डिमांड कर सकते हैं. अगर एकनाथ शिंदे 40 विधायकों के साथ 2019 में बीजेपी के साथ डील करके अपना सीएम बना सकते हैं, तो अजीत पवार और शरद पवार मिलकर एनसीपी का मुख्यमंत्री भी बना सकते हैं. ऐसी गुंजाइश को हम नकार नहीं सकते. तो ऐसे में आंकड़े क्या आते हैं, क्या एक तरफा जो है वो बहुमत जनता देती है नहीं देती है, इस पर सब कुछ निर्भर करता है. और खासतौर से जो पवार पॉलिटिक्स है वो तो हमेशा ही चर्चा का विषय रही है.
अच्छा, तो गिव मी अ मिनट हियर, बिकॉज लेट्स क्विकली अपडेट आवर व्यूअर्स ऑन द नंबर्स एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू गेट इन माय अदर गेस्ट. द बीजेपी इन द लीड इन महाराष्ट्र, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, अगेन लीड्स. They have to concretize into wins. These numbers will change, and these numbers will change very rapidly. These are only early trends. It's 8:18. Right now, only postal ballots are being counted. It is only at 8:30 that counting will begin. There are 6,000 teams across the state of Maharashtra that will be involved in this process. So it's going to be an elaborate process. And what is being pointed out to me is, and I'm just saying this to give you perspective, that in some seats, the counting will go into 30 rounds, ladies and gentlemen, 30 rounds. Devendra Fadnavis ahead in Nagpur. We believe Ajit Pawar is trailing in Baramati, but very early leads, ladies and gentlemen. Devendra Fadnavis, I mean, he has to win his seat in Nagpur. That's a sure shot. That is a given. Devendra Fadnavis ahead in Nagpur. The lead face of the BJP in these elections has campaigned in this election, in fact, strategized this election from the front. He is the chief ministerial face as far as the BJP is concerned, or at least as far as the RSS is concerned. Because do remember when the exit poll figures came in and when they gave a clear edge to the Mahayuti, well, what was the first thing that Devendra Fadnavis did? He went and met RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat. Why did he do that? It was a Thanksgiving exercise, we are told, because the RSS, which was fairly upset with the BJP till 6 months ago, which is why they didn't pitch in with the elections, this time stepped in to help out Devendra Fadnavis and the BJP. Not the Mahavikas Agadi, ladies and gentlemen, not the Mahayuti, I beg your pardon, not the Shiv Sena faction, not the NCP faction, but the BJP. But the RSS was very clear that if the BJP emerges as the single largest party within the alliance or even outside the alliance, it is Devendra Fadnavis who needs to be the chief minister. There'll be no compromise on that. We'll see how things play out, because a lot will depend not just on how the coalition shapes up or how the coalition performs, both coalitions, but also how individual parties perform in this coalition. So the big news coming in so far, and as I said, these are early leads, they will change. Ajit Pawar now leading, as I said, ladies and gentlemen, things will change very quickly. We are just giving you breaking as it is coming. Devendra Fadnavis clearly ahead in Nagpur, and from and we are also being told that Devendra Fadnavis is ahead in Nagpur. And of course, the other seat which everyone has an eye on is down south. Not in Maharashtra, but down south, ladies and gentlemen. That is Wayanad. Many people are saying Priyanka didn't even need to campaign. She would have won the seat. Perhaps, perhaps not. But this is her electoral debut. And we are being told that she is ahead. The numbers seem to suggest that she is ahead at the moment. Let's quickly go across to our guests who are joining me this evening. Chandrasekhar Jha, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena of the UBT faction. We'll come to the chief ministerial question later. But any comments on the leads that you're seeing right now? It seems the lead at 8:22 a.m. this morning is with the BJP as far as Maharashtra is concerned. 34 for the BJP and, of course, for the entire alliance, 53.
These are the early trends because till afternoon we'll come to know what is the exact result and what will be the situation in Maharashtra. But eventually, if I can say that the Maharashtra follows the trend, what Lok Sabha shows the way. So, if 2019 can also be seen, is the Lok Sabha results which paved the way for the assembly seats in 2019. But eventually, the thing is that the results will show all the things clearly what will happen in Maharashtra and what will be the fate of the divide and rule policy of BJP. So, all the things will be decided in this result, and we believe that we are going to form the government, and categorically, the state will be at least be having a good governance. We believe that the BJP will not do the politics of divide and rule in the parties again for forming the government.
Okay, but here's the point. Even if the BJP does divide and rule, the point is the weakness is within your own camp. If people are willing to be sold off for money and positions, nah. So that is one point we always have to keep in mind. Ashutosh Mishra, you're a senior journalist. You're joining us on the broadcast as well, I believe. Early leads coming in, BJP plus, which means the Mahayuti Alliance at 63, the Congress at 46. Early leads, but how are you reading what is coming to us right now? Ashutosh Mishra, can you hear me? Okay, Ashutosh is not with us. Then let me quickly go across to Gautam Seth, who is joining us on the broadcast as well. He is spokesperson of the Congress party. Gautam Seth, thank you very much. As we wait for Ashutosh to join us, any comments, any remarks on the early leads that are coming in? It seems that the Mahavikas Agadi at 8:24 is trailing. But again, I'm saying in some seats, there are 30 rounds that need to be counted. This is just the first or the second round. So a long way to go. But anyhow, these are the early leads. Any comments?
Absolutely. As you say yourself, that these are the early trends and we need to wait for things to unfold. As far as the Mahavikas Agadi is concerned in Maharashtra and the Congress and the JMM is concerned in Jharkhand, we are very confident that we have fought an election that was an election which people related from. an election where people saw their issues being highlighted. And I think because of that, people resonated with our alliances in both these states. And we are very hopeful that we are going to form the government with a clear majority in both these states. But yes, we must wait because these are the early trends. So let things unfold. And I'm sure that the kind of response we got from people in both these states, we should be able to form the government.
No, you are very hopeful. All that is very well. But DK Shivakumar yesterday is saying that, you know, if there is a win, it'll be by a slight margin. We have our helicopters ready. Our MLAs, all after collecting the certificate, will straight away report to Mumbai. There is a coordination committee that has already been formed to look into the post-poll scenario. If, sir, all of this is true, then clearly it's good for you to display the confidence that you are displaying right now, but neither side should be having that sort of confidence, given what exit polls are saying.
I think, sadly, post-2014, the way the democratic structure of the country has been attacked time and again by the Prime Minister, the Home Minister and the agencies that work as the frontal organizations of the BJP, it has become a sad reality for all of us to protect the sanctity of the election, because the sanctity of the election has always been put to danger by the forces in the central government, sometimes by the Raj Bhavans. We have seen how they function, and it is better, you know, precaution is better than cure. So we are taking all the precautions. We have to take all the precautions, because such is an era that we live in where the central government is hell-bent to steal away the sanctity of the voters' vote. We have seen that happening in Maharashtra itself. So we need to be very much well prepared in advance, and we are prepared for it.
But let's not forget that last time the BJP had actually emerged as the single largest party, and it was Devendra Fadnavis who was sworn in as the chief minister. Now, of course, his government fell in 5 days is a different issue. But Ali Daruwala, would you want to come in here? The charge is against the BJP. BJP will do anything to retain power. Kahin se bhi, kitna bhi paisa karke, chopper karke, resort politics karke, they will do their best to form the government by unethical means as well. So it is necessary for us to protect our troops. What can we do? This is the sad reality of Indian elections post 2014. This is what the Congress spokesperson is saying.
Correct. What he said, now you can see the body language, the way they are playing defensive, already their statements. See, I will tell you one thing, over here we need to understand the trends are starting. They are saying the trends are going to trail and they are just leading and they are, but the narrative sets in the first 1 hour and that trend is not broken. Nevertheless, we are going to take it with humility, as I told you, with humility. And yeah, I will tell you, but this magical figures are really difficult to break. What he's saying, what happened in 2019, we came with power. We were betrayed. I am time and again saying we were betrayed as to why that happened. The full world saw you were there at that point in time. Let us not do this. At this point in time, we are having a very comfortable win. You can see the aura.
Oops. The aura has frozen for the moment. Advocate Sushil Vyas, your spokesperson of the Shiv Sena of the Shinde faction, joining us as well. You know, there are already indications that Sharad Pawar is reaching out to MLAs of the Ajit Pawar faction. Are you hearing of any such thing as far as the Shiv Sena is concerned? Is the Uddhav Thackeray Sena reaching out to your MLAs or vice versa? Because ye khel to pichle 48 hours se chal raha hai here. Everyone is speaking to everyone. Anything can happen if the numbers are not clear.
Good morning, Shreya ji. This kind of talk we are listening for last 2.5 years, the day on which the Ekna Shinde ji taken oath as a chief minister. 5 days, people will walk over, that cross over, they are in touch with that. Not a single MLA went back to the Uddhav Thackeray. So question is, from there, some people may come here by the evening, but from our side, not a single person is going to go there. So we are strongly united and we have full confidence in the kind of response we got during the campaign. That gives us confidence that we are going to form government by today evening.
So the rest is sure, the numbers that are on your screens.
Yeah. Yeah, 71.
May give you some reason to smile, but I just want to correct. Mr. Daruwala. Mr. Daruwala is saying that the trends concretize more or less the way an election is going. You get to know the trends in the first 1 hour. But Mr. Daruwala's point is that is not how Haryana played out. You remember, Haryana for the first couple of hours was being given to who? To the Congress Party. वहाँ जलेबी भी बनना शुरू हो गया था. But look what ultimately happened. The BJP won the state. अब पॉइंट है कि बीजेपी हेडक्वार्टर में दिस मॉर्निंग जलेबी बनना शुरू हो गया है. सो आई होप व्हाट हैपेंड टू द कांग्रेस पार्टी इन हरियाणा डजंट हैपन टू द बीजेपी इन महाराष्ट्र. एनी हाउ, आशुतोष जी इज अ सीनियर जर्नलिस्ट. ही इज जॉइनिंग अस ऑन द ब्रॉडकास्ट. आशुतोष जी, यू हैव कवर्ड मेनी इलेक्शंस. आई जस्ट वॉन्ट यू टू गिव अस पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन द नंबर्स वी आर सीइंग. एंड आई वॉन्ट यू टू टेल आर व्यूअर्स वाई द नंबर्स वी आर सीइंग are just early leads and early trends and by no means an indication on which way the election will ultimately go. Because for us to decide which way the election has gone, we will have to wait. We will have to wait for the Election Commission website to actually start giving us concrete wins. And that will be clear only by 12 o'clock.
And one example that you have given is why we should not trust these numbers is Haryana. Before that, the same thing had happened to BJP in Bihar. They had started distributing laddus, and we all know in the end what happened. So it's hard to trust these numbers right now. Yeah, you can be upbeat, whichever party is leading right now. If you even see the results of the Lok Sabha elections, it was a close fight. The MVA may have got more seats, but in terms of the voting percentage, the Mahayuti and Mahavikas Aghadi were very close to each other. And that's what makes this fight interesting. Because obviously, before the election, so many economic benefits were doled out by the Shinde government, which pointed to the fact that they realized that they are actually on the back foot and they have to woo the rural areas of Maharashtra where they don't have the same sort of appeal when it comes to their slogans. And that is what will be the deciding factor in a way, whether they have been able to address the grievances of the farmers, of the unemployed, of the women who were so hit by the economic uncertainties, and whether the electorate has accepted their excuse that it was the MVA to blame when the all the projects were being shifted to Gujarat or not. And it's what it is more interesting is what you were saying about post-poll politics. Because, you know, there was a slogan that jahan BJP ko majority milti hai, wahan to BJP sarkar banati hai. Jahan nahi milti, wahan to pakka banati hai. So this is what is about post-poll alliances that happen as at Shinde government itself is an example of that. Yeah.
Okay. Abhi nahi banayegi, toh baad mein banayegi. They don't give up. And that's a positive that honestly goes in the BJP's favor. Because, you know, it's do or die. When you fight an election, you fight an election to win. And even if you lose the election, you somehow try and, you know, win it as time goes along. You know, there's some khichdi. I just wonder if we still have Rakesh with us. Give me a minute here. I just would want to know if Rakesh is still with us. Because I do want to go across to him. There is something interesting that is happening, ladies and gentlemen, because Dr. Naveen Kumar, spokesperson of the Ajit Pawar faction, who was supposed to join us, has not joined us. And Dr. Sameer Dalwai, who's spokesperson of the NCP Sharad Pawar faction, who was supposed to join us, has not joined us. Ab kuch to ho raha hai. There is something happening, ladies and gentlemen, within the NCP. What it is, I do not know. We will know. But what the Sharad Pawar faction has said is that we are already in touch with people on the other side, on the side of Ajit Pawar. So there is some interesting khichdi that is happening there. Gautam Seth, again, as we look at these numbers, fact is we need to keep some electoral history in mind. Fact is that in the last 34 years, Maharashtra has never given a single party 144/145 numbers that are required to form the government, right? So in the last 34 years, what has become a mainstay for Maharashtra's politics is not just the Khichdi, but coalition politics. So even this time, irrespective of which party is the single largest party, it will be a coalition that will rule the state of Maharashtra. I want to ask you, you are projecting confidence. You are saying the Mahavikas Agadi is the one going to win. My point is, you have Uddhav Thackeray this morning, and we've just seen pictures from outside Matoshri that are coming in, that are pitching him as the chief minister. Then Nana Patole comes in as, and says, bhai, chief minister to main banunga. So, so even before, actually, the results have come in, there is already a ladai jhagda over who the chief minister is going to be. You may or may not get the numbers, who knows?
No, not at all. I don't think there is any kind of confusion out there. The alliances which have fought the Maharashtra election are pre-poll alliances. They are not going to be post-poll alliances. And when pre-poll alliances are formed and we go to the people and ask for vote, you know, we set an agenda, which is the common minimum program of the alliance, and the election is fought on that common minimum program. As far as the question of who is going to lead the government, once the numbers are out there, it is all the alliance partners who are going to sit together and make a very clear decision on it, with the elected members of the Legislative Assembly making a final decision. So that is how the democratic process has been. And there is no confusion, no infighting at all within the Congress or within the alliance partners, which we see at all happening. And it is very clear that there was a pre-poll alliance which has gone for these elections. That pre-poll alliance was formed on the issues of the people of Maharashtra. That pre-poll alliance was, inspired by the ideals of Savitribai Phule, was inspired by the ideals of how Marathas have that unflinching urge to fight for what they feel is right. And we have gone ahead to fight these elections in the same manner. And once the results are out there for everyone to see, the alliance partners will sit together and make a decision on it. There is absolutely no infighting at all.
Acha, publicly that is not what it seems like. But Advocate Sushil Vyas, you are spokesperson of the Shiv Sena Shinde faction, and I have to keep saying that because it's so confusing, right? You keep saying Shiv Sena, only to know that there's so much khichdi that for the outside viewer it becomes a little confusing ki kaun kiske saath hai. Mr. Vyas, fact is that as we speak, we have seen pictures of Mr. Shinde in Thane as chief minister once again. But fact is that we also have the BJP now openly pitching for Devendra Fadnavis as Maharashtra's next chief minister. So if there is khicha tani, as we say, in the Maha Vikas Agadi, there is khicha tani even in the Mahayuti.
Confusion of any nature whatsoever as far as Mahayuti is concerned. We fought this election under the able leadership of Eknath Rao Shinde. But as far as the chief ministerial candidate is concerned, time and again we have said, and our leadership has also went on record saying that after the election, our newly elected MLAs will come together and they will elect their leader and he will be our chief minister. So there is no confusion. There is no fight. Our sole motto is that Mahayuti should be there in power. And that we are working for that, we are getting that. Yeah, and you will see that.
But Rahul Narvekar...
Yeah.
But Rahul Narvekar is already saying that Mr. Fadnavis is an acceptable face to everyone. And therefore, he is a prospective chief minister. My point is, are you telling me, dekhi, aisa hai statistically, if you see, then the maximum number of seats in the alliance have been fought by who? They've been fought by the BJP. So statistically, they could emerge as the single largest party within your alliance. If that happens and every MLA votes, then the vote is going to Devendra Fadnavis. Will he be acceptable to you?
Sriyaji, for last 2.5 years, when we are running this government, BJP is largest party. Single largest party. They are having 105 MLAs, we are having 41 MLAs. Still, there is an understanding.
We are smoothly running. Voting hoga.
अच्छा वोटिंग होगा तो दैट इज अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजन.
बोला वोटिंग होगा.
सी विथ रेस्पेक्ट दैट इज अ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजन. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड्स न्यूली इलेक्टेड एमएलए हैज टू कम टुगेदर हैव अ मीटिंग एंड दे हैव टू इलेक्ट ऑफिशियली दैट हु विल गो टू गवर्नर हाउस एंड स्टेक अ क्लेम फॉर फॉर्मिंग गवर्नमेंट. सो दैट इज अ प्रोसीजर एज लेट डाउन इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. सो वी विल फॉलो दैट बट देयर वोंट बी एनी कंफ्यूजन एंड डिस्प्यूट.
वोटिंग होगा तो देवेंद्र फडणवीस. Okay, so voting hota to Devendra Fadnavis will come out Trump, right? Because that will emerge as the single largest party within your alliance. Statistically speaking, wo to kuch bhi sakta hai, but statistically speaking, I'm asking you, will he be acceptable to you?
Anybody who is elected as a leader of newly elected MLAs of Mahayuti will be acceptable to us. Maybe X, Y, Z, anyone.
Dr. Sameer Dalwai. Dr. Sameer Dalwai, spokesperson of the NCP of the Sharad Pawar faction, you hadn't joined us and I had a conspiracy theory. Hello sir, good morning. I had a conspiracy theory ki NCP mein kuch khichri pak raha hai. Because Dr. Naveen Kumar, spokesperson of the Ajit Pawar faction, had not joined us either. And the news that came to us while both of you were absent is that there are some members from your party who are also in touch with members from the Ajit Pawar faction. Is that true or not? And since when has this contact been established? And what is the purpose, sir?
So, good morning, Shreyaji. First and foremost, Naveen and I haven't been having coffee together or something like that. We are both in our own places. The second part that you said about people being in touch in Maharashtra, why only the two, the NCP in Maharashtra, the beauty of Maharashtra politics has been that there has been no personal enmity between people, leaders ever, maybe except the last couple of years. Because otherwise, the Sanskruti, jise hum kehte hain Maharashtra ki, is about a progressive Sanskruti, about working together. Elections are one thing, but being in touch is definitely not anathema or was not anathema. So there have been, these are parties which have been broken up recently thanks to you know who. But people have been in touch with each other and they might be. But it has nothing to do with having a conspiracy or doing cooking any khichdi behind anybody's back. Not at all.
No, but Mr. Ajit Pawar has said things which will sound rosy to Mr. Sharad Pawar's ears. For example, he has also said at one point that, look, it was a mistake for me to field my wife against my sister. So there are overtures that Mr. Ajit Pawar has also tried to make to Mr. Sharad Pawar. Are you telling me all that has not cut any ice with him? That if Mr. Ajit Pawar wants to come back, Mr. Sharad Pawar will say, nahi, tum dur raho, humko tumse kuch lena dena nahi hai. Hard to believe, na, Dr. Sameer?
Even you never know, but that's not the position at all right now. We don't need any other bit to join us back again because it's very clear that they were decimated. That faction was decimated in the Lok Sabha and it's very clear who is the real party. And it's, of course, the party led by Honorable Sharad Pawar ji. And there is no reason for it to cut any ice with us. Mr. Ajit Pawar is free to express his sentiments, emotional or political. Nobody can stop that. That is his right. But that doesn't mean we are banking on it or we need it. We don't. We have already established our entity. The Election Commission was to, the Supreme Honorable Supreme Court was to give a result on the, in fact, the symbol as well. For some reason, best known to others, it has not come out. But it's very clear. Just last week, they said, learn to fight on your own. Why are you using other people? So I think it's very clear right now. And I think by the end of this day, or in fact, by afternoon, as you mentioned earlier, things will be very clear who the people of Maharashtra trust and who the people of Maharashtra want to lead Maharashtra.
Okay, Ali Daruwala wanted to come in at some point of time. I just hope, like all of you, that the results are decisive, the results are clear. Otherwise, I mean, politicians can, you know, do what they want to do with their Sunday. But I care about the taxpayers' money being spent on resort politics and on choppers to ferry MLAs from one state to another just to keep them safe. Ali Daruwala, you had a point to make, but before I come to you, let me quickly just update our viewers on the numbers we are seeing on our screens right now as far as the state of Maharashtra is concerned. They are on your screens everywhere. Wherever you look, there's a breakup and there is an amalgamated figure as well. So leads in, out of 288 seats, leads in 235. The BJP-led alliance running way ahead of the Congress-led alliance. The BJP plus at 126, which means the Mahayuti is at 126. That's what the alliance is known in Maharashtra. What about the Mahavikas Agari, the Congress, Shiv Sena and the NCP alliance, the breakaway factions, that is, 103. So that is where the leads stand right now. Others at 8. At some point of time, will the others, will the independents, will the smaller parties, will the rebels become important to how Maharashtra forms its next government? That is a possibility, ladies and gentlemen, but it's only 8:45. I want to keep adding this caveat at the risk of repeating myself over and over again like a broken record. The fact is that it's only 8:45. These are only leads. They may or may not concretize into wins. Do remember that in at least 80 seats, in at least 80 seats, the contest is going to be very, very close. So close that one major sophologist in Maharashtra categorically in his exit poll has said that 61 seats are too close to call. I'm not even risking my reputation on them. So there will be seats, about 80 seats to 90 seats, that will be too close to call, where the competition is very, very tight, where the margins will be very, very low. Again, there are some seats that will go into 30 rounds of counting. So all of that will take time. 8:45 a.m., early leads seem to suggest that it is the Mahayuti that is walking away with Maharashtra. But I just want to remind our viewers, Ali Daruwala, as I get you in, I just want to remind my viewers, let's not make the mistake that was made during Haryana. In Haryana, early leads all went to the Congress party. And then what happened post 10:30 a.m.? The tide began to change. Will the tide change in the favor of the Mahavikas Agadi in this case? We don't know. We don't know how these elections will go. And by God, Ali Daruwala, this has possibly been the most complex election in India's electoral history.
Yeah, Shreya, am I audible? Am I there on the screen now?
Loud and clear. Yeah. Go ahead, please.
Yeah. Shreya, let me tell you, you were trying to get Advocate Vyas and you were trying to corner him and ask him, like, who's going to be the chief minister candidate. And as per the statistics and as per the logic goes, that since we have the larger number and our candidate will be the chief minister, let me clarify here. As a BJP spokesperson, I'm making it very clear. The candidate elect are going to sit together, and I can assure you nothing of that sort is going to be decided in Maharashtra. No one has the power and no one has the capacity to decide the chief minister candidate. It is in the center where it will be decided. Whatever the formula is over here, there are certain ethics that we have followed and certain commitments that we have followed, which we are not going to go back. And over here, what we need to understand over here is we came to power and we could perform the 2.5 years that we got the chance to bring the leadership and the flagship programs back into Maharashtra was thanks to Eknath Shindeji and later Ajit Pawar. Anyway, forget about this battle of who's going to be the CM. What is very important now, if you can see the leads, out of 288, 256 seats, results are almost out. We are, Mahayuti is ahead. Agadi is behind.
No. Early leads. Ali Daruwala, early leads. These are not results. Correct. I just want to keep telling you. These are not results.
I'll tell you one thing. See, we are going to have a very early wind-up today. I think by 11:30, 12, we can all go home and rest for the rest of the day. I'll tell you why. Over here, what needs to be understood is everything was rubbish. Ajit Pawar was a mistake and we shouldn't have gone and we have suffered because of Ajit Pawar. No, we did not suffer in Maharashtra and the party did not get a bad name. Ajit Pawar is a very tall leader. He cannot be discounted. Now, look at the trends. Ajit Pawar is already at neck to neck with Sharad Pawar. Over here, it was written that Sharad Pawar has done the magic and he's out in the rain and 85-year-old is working so hard. Yeah, that was all okay, entertainment. But on the ground results is Sharad Pawar and Ajit Pawar. Though being such a small, hardly 40, 45 seats that he fought in, he's already leading in most of the seats that he has won. The fun begins here to see from Baramati what happened, what people, they took all this for entertainment. And what they have gone down and pressed the button is for Vikas. So this is what it is. And definitely, you need to run a show. You need TRP. You need to throw in balls. People do get trapped in your... Shreya, in your thing, like who's going to be CM, they get little baffled when they answer you. But the fact is very clear. We are very confident. And I am going ahead telling you there is nothing of this. No hotel rooms are booked. Choppers are not being booked. It's going to be a very comfortable lead. But with humility, we need to take this. And there are people in the party like who like to, you know, suck up to their leaders and portray them as CM face, put up banners. That does happen. They have that unteam respect for their leader. So this is going to happen. But let us not encash into it and say this is the trend, is a trail. And that's what I'd like to say, Shreya.
Okay. But here's the point, Mr. Daruvala. You're saying a lot of that happens. A lot of what happens on, in TV studios, even in the political arena, is entertainment. Woh toh, I give you that, right? I give you that, 100%. But my point is, look at Ajit Pawar's utterances during this election. When Yogi Adityanath grandly came into Maharashtra as the BJP star campaigner and said, "Batenge to katenge." What was Ajit Pawar's response? Open response. These are outsiders. They don't understand the ethics and the values and the social fabric of the state of Maharashtra, right? He said that openly. When the Prime Minister was coming down, he said, "I don't need any tall leader to come to Baramati to campaign for me. Thank you very much. Kis kahin aur bhej do unko, meri jagah aane ki zarurat nahi hai."
This is the confidence,
Mr. and
that is, with due respect, I'll tell you, he said that Narendra Modi ji need not come to Baramati and waste his precious time. He is capable and he is competent to handle. And how competent he was, you can see with the early figures that are coming in. It's a very comfortable move. It's a walk in the park for Ajit Pawar. As I always kept saying, as a spokesperson for BJP, you can pick up the track record. For last 6 months, I was the only person who kept on supporting Ajit Pawar and kept saying that, no, it's not a mistake. He is a tall leader. He is a local politician. Maharashtra ke andar Ajit Pawar card chalenga. Because when Sharad Pawar ji was in the back seat, it was Ajit Pawar for 35 years. He led the party. And in time ke upar, to portray his daughter, he cut wings of Ajit Pawar. People, the locals, forget Maharashtra. In Baramati itself, he has been rejected. Not on money power, not on muscle power, but on principle. Now you can see, with all due respect to our senior Mr. leader, Sharad Pawar, people took him for entertainment. But what actually is happening into the EVMs is going to turn out. And they're really going to fare very badly.
Okay, we do not know if the Mahayuti is going to reverse. Yes, Mr. Dalvi, you want to come in? We don't know if they'll reverse the trend of 6 months ago, but just take a look at the election results that came in 6 months ago, Mr. Daruvala. And I wonder whether you have all the reasons to be that confident, because just 6 months ago, the alliance, your alliance, had not performed very well. 17 seats versus 30 for the Mahavikas Agadi. Now, this time, what has happened very interestingly is that from last time, 70 lakh more voters. I'm welcoming Dr. Uday into the broadcast as well. 70 lakh more voters have voted. Many of them, in fact, most of them are women. So has that changed the game? Many people are saying it has. But ek minute, before I get to you, Dr. Dalvi wanted to say something. Dr. Dalvi, please go ahead.
Yeah, so my name is Dalvai, but that's okay. Many people make that error. But I just wanted to respond to what Mr. Daruvala said.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Don't worry. It's all right.
Dalvi.
It's very obvious that Mr. Daruvala has not visited Baramati during this election process at all. Because what he's saying is fabricated, is sitting in studios here or in Bombay. I was in Baramati on the 18th. That was the last day of the campaign. And I could see what the vibe was. And I don't need to say it, because anybody was there could see it, that it's only and only for Mr. Sharad Pawar. So to cook up these theoretical possibilities sitting in studios in Bombay doesn't cut on the ground in Maharashtra, that too in rural Maharashtra. The second point I wanted to make, what you are saying, Shreyaji, I did not see a single BJP flag in that entire constituency and even in the surrounding constituencies. And the reason for Mr. Ajit Pawar not welcoming Mr. Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji into his constituency.
No, not welcoming, it's a gesture.
Because let me finish, Mr. Daruvala, what happened? And the reason for him not welcoming Mr. Modi ji there to his constituency is because that would have been a sure shot way of him losing votes, because there is no support to BJP or BJP ideology in that region of Maharashtra at all. And that is why, in his wisdom, he has chosen rather impolitely or politely, but not to invite Mr. Modi to his constituency. So I just wanted to clarify some facts on the ground as to what Mr. Daruvala had said. Thank you.
Doctor there.
Yeah.
You are coming in on the broadcast. Good morning to you. You have a long day. Early leads. We are just about hitting 9 o'clock. It's 8:55. Early leads seem to be very kind to the BJP-led alliance in the state. Aapne to khair bhavishyavani kari rakhi hai that it is the Mahayuti that will form the next government in Maharashtra as well. But any comments on these early leads that are coming in?
Yeah, still I will not say that Mahayuti has though improved little situation than what it was 25 minutes back. But I would say, I would keep my fingers crossed, because there are about 60 seats where there is a photo finish. But what I have network across Maharashtra in almost all talukas, and I'm on my laptop on one side and mobile on a couple of sides, I'm getting information is some of the ministers in the current list are trailing badly. So that's also one news. And second news is Ajit Pawar is little ahead than the NCP Sharad Pawar got, which, and so also Eknath Shinde is ahead of Uddhav Thackeray. So that's also a very interesting trend, which is seen. Sudhir Gadge from Sangli is leading. And if that's the trend setting, then the entire Western Maharashtra will vote differently. So some of the things are quite interesting, I would say. Let's see how it unfolds. Nobody should jump the gun at this point of time. Wo Abdullah ki shaadi mein Abdullah diwana aisa nahi hona chahiye. Thoda ruko, sabr karo. Sabr ka fal meetha hota hai. Maine nahi, ye kisi santon ne kaha hai, to unki to baat suniye kam se kam. To all the political spokesperson should not criticize each other. Kahin shaam ko ek dusre ke saath बैठकर सत्ता का मौका करने की नौबत ना आ जाए.
Dr. Oday, but point is there are no permanent friends or enemies, you know, in politics. And as far as Maharashtra is concerned, the good doctor on the panel is telling me, in any case, most politicians have friendly relationship with each other, irrespective of which party or faction they belong to. So, kuch bhi ho sakta, essentially. You know, I am also going to look at the numbers that are coming in on the Election Commission website, ladies and gentlemen, because ultimately it is the Election Commission that will declare who the winner of this election is and who the loser of this election is. Theek hai? So, that being said, right now, I'm just looking at the 288. I'm looking at 288 assembly constituencies here and seeing what the Election Commission is saying, and this data is coming from the Election Commission website. So it seems that the Mahayuti is ahead according to the Election Commission. These are again leads that they are saying. 4-1 is the lead that the Election Commission is giving the Mahayuti. The BJP is at 1. I just have a breakup now. The BJP is at 1. The NCP Sharad Pawar faction is at 1. The NCP, which is Ajit Pawar, is at 3. And the Shinde Sena is at 3 as well. So that is coming in from the Election Commission website. But the numbers, of course, when it comes to private agencies, is much faster, which is why you're seeing the numbers on your screens, where the BJP, ladies and gentlemen, as we speak, the alliance it leads, called the Mahayuti, which is the ruling coalition in the state of Maharashtra, comprises of the Shiv Sena and the NCP of Eknath Shinde and Ajit Pawar. They are clearly in the lead as far as early leads are concerned, 138 for them. And as far as the Congress is concerned, it is 126. Dr. Oday, before I get the political guests in, could this turn out to be close? Because it's not like the BJP-led alliance is racing ahead.
Yeah, but ultimately what I see picture is that BJP, single largest party emerging, and the Mahavikas, Mahayuti is emerging as the single largest alliance. That's what it now coming to. Mm. But it's not that Mahavikas Aghadi has to give up the battle and say that goodbye, we are not joining on the channel. They still have the hope, in my opinion, that even if they do what it is predicted on currently on this on the screen, it's not a bad scenario. It's not a bad scenario for them. They have done, as of now, they have not done bad, although they would have loved to see doing much better. But abhi bhi fight open hai, lekin wo BJP ke paksh mein hai.
Abhi bhi fight open hai, lekin BJP ke paksh mein hai, which means that there is one person who could emerge as kingmaker, and that person's name is Ajit Pawar. Is there a possibility, according to you, him switching sides and going back to his uncle?
Yes, no, that may not be the possibility. He will stick to Mahayuti, in my opinion. He will not go to Mahavikas Aghadi. Of course, it depends on number. It may so happen in the end that Ajit Pawar's importance, as we see it today, may not be as strong as it was painted before the counting. If BJP crosses 100 or touches 100 and Eknath Shinde touches 35, then the importance of Ajit Pawar reduces slightly. And I don't see any possibility of him joining with uncle at this point of time, unless they offer him chief ministership, which is rather difficult. Uddhav Thackeray will not accept it.
True. And also, it's probably safer for him to stay with the BJP, given the number of corruption charges against him and given the fear of the ED and the CBI as well.
No, there is another factor to it.
Dr. Uday?
BJP doesn't have the Maratha face. BJP doesn't have the Maratha face as tall as Eknath Shinde and Ajit Pawar at this point of time. They have a taller person, but that's Brahmin, that's not Maratha. So we need to see how the voting has taken place in Pashchim Maharashtra and Marathwada 3 district, Bid, Jalna and Latur Dharashiv, in that area, how the voting has captured. But what signals I'm getting from that area is that Mahayuti is ahead, and which is quite significant. As I said, a minority caste Brahmin person, Sudhir Gadge, surging ahead in Sangli, which is the heart of Western Maharashtra and once a bastion of Congress, is something interesting. Even in Indapur, we see Datta Bharane of Ajit Pawar Gut, who is leading. That's also a very significant Ram Kadam leading in Mumbai. That's also the trend setting, I would say, for Mumbai seats.
Okay.
But I get some information
but in the last 6 months has...
Yeah, tell me.
But you know, point is, in the last 6 months, has anything changed? I'll just get in reactions here, but the point also is, in the last 6 months, has anything changed for the Marathas to abandon the Mahavikas Aghadi and go to the Mahayuti? Given the fact that they're fairly upset about Maratha reservation, right? So there is no reason, as of now, at least by the looks of it, we don't know how things pan out. Maybe the Latki Behen Yojana actually ends up getting some part of the woman Maratha vote to their kitty. But who knows? Who knows how things play out? Give me a minute here. I need to play out some sound bites and I'm coming back straight to you.
क्या लग रहा है आपको, किन मुद्दों पर आपको ये आशीर्वाद मिलेगा, जनता का आशीर्वाद मिलेगा?
मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि सवा दो वर्षों से महाराष्ट्र की सरकार ने जिस तरीके से काम किया है और जिस तरीके से लोक जन कल्याणकारी योजनाएं लागू की है और उसका जिस तरीके से उनको सीधे लाभ मिला है डीबीटी के जरिए, उनके अकाउंट में मदद की राशि जा रही है, सम्मान की राशि जा रही है, उसका बहुत बड़ा फायदा होगा और लोग चाहते हैं कि इस प्रकार की, देखो क्या है, पिछली जो सरकार थी वो जनता का पैसा लेकर के अपने जेब में भर रही थी, घोटाले कर रही थी, खिचड़ी घोटाला, ये घोटाला, वो घोटाला, कोविड के समय घोटाले हुए, हर तरह के घोटाले हुए, इस सरकार पर कोई आरोप नहीं, कोई दाग नहीं, घटोगे तो कटोगे, इस घोषणा में कोई कमी नहीं है, कोई मुझे खराबी नहीं दिखती, सिर्फ अंग्रेज कहते थे, अंग्रेज करते थे, फूट डालो राज करो, डिवाइड एंड रूल करते थे, वो हमारे समाज को बांट के रखते थे। उसके बाद कांग्रेस पार्टी ने यही किया कि समाज को बांट के रखो ताकि जो बिखराव होगा उसकी आग पे अपनी रोटी सेके। महायुति का मुख्यमंत्री बनेंगे ये तय है।
आप चाहेंगे कि एकनाथ शिंदे रिपीट
हो? देखते हैं जो भी हो।
ओके, Ladies and gentlemen, there's a piece of breaking news coming in as we keep a close watch on the leads that are coming to us from India's richest state, Maharashtra, also India's third largest state, ladies and gentlemen. By the looks of it, and it's 9 o'clock, 8:30, approximately 8 o'clock is when the postal ballots have opened. For the moment, in the first 1 hour of counting, ladies and gentlemen, it seems, by the looks of it, with the numbers coming in, that it is the Mahayuti that is doing better than the Mahavikas Agadi, though the numbers are very rapidly changing. And let me point out, these are only early leads. It's only by 10:30, 11 that the picture will become slightly clear. But if you look at the numbers now, rapidly changing, the BJP plus at 136, the Congress plus at 130, which is why the others, which is rebels and smaller parties and independents, who become very important. But again, a clear picture only post 12 o'clock is the way we look at it. Many pollsters had actually given the state to the Mahayuti. Did they jump the gun? We don't know. We'll just wait and watch. For the moment, it seems that the Mahavikas Agadi has gotten into action. We know that a three-member committee has already been formed by the Congress party to look at all possible post-poll scenarios. Now, the lead of this coordination committee, as it is being called, is Ashok Gehlot, who is the former chief minister of Rajasthan. This team also comprises of Bhupesh Baghel and G. Parmeshwara. We believe that Mr. Gehlot has now reached Mumbai. Our reporters are joining us on the ground. Abhishek with us, Shweta with us. Shweta, any more details coming in? We understand that Mr. Gehlot is in. Is Mr. Baghel and Mr. Parmeshwara in as well? Are they expected to fly in by today? Or will they wait for another couple of hours before they decide whether it is worth the money and the time and the effort to come to Mumbai?
Well, sure, absolutely. In fact, we have been witnessing neck-to-neck fight in the state of Maharashtra as far as both the alliances are concerned. And here, as we speak about Mahavikas Agadi, yes, three names as given as observers from the Congress party, they will be coming down to Mumbai. In fact, as we believe, Mr. Gehlot was here till 19th of November. In fact, he was here. He took many press conferences. And right now also, we are outside NCP party. But as far as Congress is concerned, we know that they have been appointed as the observers. In fact, they have taken many press conferences also. Congress party, as to be believed, they have bagged the higher number of seats as far as the seat allocation was concerned. And now we see that in Vidarbha region, they are getting an edge. It will be important to see what about the other belts of Maharashtra, what response do they actually fetch from the Janta.
Okay. Arunil, you're joining us from outside Devendra Fadnavis's residence. He is the man who in many ways, at least as far as the BJP is concerned, is the chief ministerial face of the alliance. Are you hearing anything from him at all? Because there are his own party leaders like Rahul Narvekar who are already pitching him as the chief minister of the state. Are you hearing from him at all?
Well, that is right. Good morning to you, Shreya. His party leaders, basically, they are his close confidant, be it Rahul Narvekar, who was the speaker of the last assembly of the Maharashtra government, of the Mahayuti government, or be it these other leaders who have been pushing for Devendra Fadnavis's name. But will these people speaking really matter? That is the main question that arises, Shreya. The reason for that is, we have covered elections in Chhattisgarh, in Rajasthan, in Madhya Pradesh as well, recent state elections. All the heavyweights or the CM faces were removed by the BJP and new faces were given in those states. Whether the same thing will be applicable over here, too early to predict anything. Because till now as well, it looks like there is going to be a close finish in the state of Maharashtra. It's a neck-to-neck battle. Yes, the Mahayuti is leading, but what about Ajit Pawar? Is Ajit Pawar going to play his cards? Because we have seen many of the leaders that from the Ajit Pawar faction that I've been speaking to personally off the record, they say that expect the dynamics to change in Maharashtra once the results are out. Obviously, they can play their cards only when it is a close contest, only when the BJP is in a position that the government will fall. They will not be able to form a government if Ajit Pawar is not with them. Interesting dynamics will clearly come into the picture. Okay. If we rewind back to 2019 as well, BJP and a united Shiv Sena were easily forming the government. But it took 36 days, dramatic days, dramatic sequence of events. We covered all of it. First, Devendra Fadnavis having that early morning swearing in with Ajit Pawar. It lasted only for 1.5 days. And then the unthinkable basically took place. Congress and Shiv Sena joining hands, two ideologically different partners. This time as well, if it is a close finish, we can expect more drama in the state of Maharashtra. This is Maharashtra, mercurial politics at its pinnacle.